thank you so much for tuning in. You could have been doing anything else, but you chose to tune in and rock it with me. So I greatly appreciate you. Today, we're going to talk about when it's time for a team, part one, manager, with my special guest, Steve Face Riley, and on the ones and twos, guest DJ, DJ Genius. All right, so I'm going to get into it. I want to talk about some of the common questions that independent artists have about management. First, let me say, there is only so much that you can do independently. And that with people, what people miss is the amount of team effort that goes into making the artist successful. All the artists at the top have a manager, a booking agent from for different territories, a dedicated label A&R, a PR person, and so on. So the question is, when is it time for a manager? Ask yourself these questions. Are you feeling overwhelmed due to the demand of making bigger decisions for your career? Finding it hard to balance your daily schedule with recording, performing, writing, etc.? Are you hitting a wall to get into the industry after you attain success on your own? Then it's time for a manager. Independent artists today have the tools to kickstart their careers themselves, and it's imperative that they do so. Being an artist, you should interact as if you're dealing with your own business because you're being looked at as an entrepreneur. Once you create a strong demand and everyone is seeking to do business with you, from performances to collaborations to appearances and etc., now it's time for a team. Plus, you'll have a constant revenue stream so you can afford one also. So now that the ball is rolling, you need to bring in the right people on your team and ensure they can propel success to new levels. Key team members are the group of people that is closest to the artist. Often it's the manager, the agent, and the publisher. They help build the career of an artist from the ground up. And many times starting their collaborations before any ounce of success has been achieved. It's the job to shield the artist from the outside world, to take care of all the business affairs in their demand, and to find and involve other people that believe in the artist and want to work with them. Series managers sign artists. They work from a commission of 10% to 20%. The industry norm is 15%, and it's decided upon the manager's contribution to the artist's career. Most managers would take the cut off of the gross revenue, meaning all revenue without any deduction of costs. I'm going to tell you this, never sign a contract that you don't agree with, and make sure that you have your own entertainment lawyer to review it. If you and your manager cannot come to an agreement, then you should part ways before you sign on the dotted line. The terms for these agreements range from a year to 3 years. The latter is the most common. If you have a manager that believes that management is a long-term investment, then they'll present a 3-year agreement to you. The end goal is that you build something great together. So you want to work with somebody you consider as family, somebody you can trust. Another question is, what is the role of a manager? An artist manager is multifaceted as far as his roles are concerned. In essence, their primary duty is to create opportunities. Their task is to devise and execute a strategy to facilitate the artist to excel artistically and in some cases even streamlining their personal lives, to connect them to the right people, to create a state of order from which creative work is easily done, to bring the right people to the artist team and for the right reasons at the right time. To make the decisions that the artist doesn't want to make and to give the bad news that the artist doesn't want to give out. A good manager has a plan and a vision for the artist and will do everything in his or her power to make it a reality. And what I mean by that is they're coordinating and streamlining the efforts of everyone working with an artist, such as agents, publishers, PR, label A&Rs, and other people to make things happen. A manager also makes countless sale calls and pitches, negotiating contracts and relentlessly pursuing opportunities even when the odds are slim. Managers need to truly believe in their artists, without a shadow of a doubt. It's necessary for the job. They need to endlessly sell and receive a no for the answers of most of the time, and to be an objective sounding board for the artist. Being able to say so when a product or track isn't good enough, to say no. And to be critical to the outside world, filtering out the nonsense and telling people how it is with tact. And then still maintaining the belief in the destined success that comes in the future. An artist manager relationships become very personal over time. And so the best managers are involved artistically, helping to curate and develop the musical content and branding. These things concern creative ideas, which are very personal in nature. For artists to receive and appreciate feedback from their manager is necessary to establish a relationship of trust and also have respect for each other's authority on certain subjects. Later in the show, we will give you more tips about management and what it will take for you to draw a manager to you. And as well, we'll talk about a little bit about artist development, so get your notepads ready. Now for a segment called Now That's Dope. Chance the Rapper is one of the biggest independent artists out here today, who's current at the moment. And he continues to prove that he will achieve success without a major label. He openly shunned a record contract, built up an enormous fan base, and released music with his friends who are changing the industry. He's also brought back tickets from scalpers. He urged fans not to give up on trying to purchase tickets since the event was sold out. He said, "It's apparent to me that many people have targeted my cheap tickets to MCD and used me and my fans as a way to make money from music." He later said, "I'm not taking resellers. I'm putting them in your hands myself for either $45 or $75. He's a young hip hop artist who truly cares about his fan base, and that's dope. Performance opportunities. Once again, I said this on the last show, but I'm going to repeat it again. 2016 AC3 Hip Hop Festival are currently accepting late submissions. AC3 Festival and Conference is October 5th through October 9th in Atlanta. If you want more information, go to www.ac3festival.com. And I want to share this with the promoters. This is worldwide. It doesn't matter. If you have any events that you have opportunities for artists to perform, please send me your information and all the details to wwenradio@gmail.com. And I'll make sure that I broadcast that information on air. So DJ Genius, I know you can spin. So please get it in.
I'm saying that's what this is all about, right? Clothes, bank rolls, and hoes, you know what I'm saying? Yo, then what, man? What?
Visualizing the realism of life in actuality. Fuck who's the baddest, approaching status depends on salary. And my mentality is money orientated. I'm destined to live the dream for all my peeps who never made it. Cause yeah, we were beginners in the hood as proper sinners, but something must have got in us, cause all of us turned to sinners. Now some resting in peace and some are sitting in San Quentin. Others such as myself are trying to carry on tradition, keeping the sweat of wrestling, street ghetto essence inside us, cause it provides us with the proper insight that got us. Even though we know somehow we all gotta go, but as long so-so. Into that day we expire and turn to vapors. Me and my capers, I'll be somewhere stacking plenty papers. Keeping it real, packing still, getting high. Cause life's a bitch and then you die. Life's a bitch and then you die. That's why we get high, cause you never know when you're gonna go. Life's a bitch and then you die. That's why we puff fly, cause you never know when you're gonna go. Life's a bitch and then you die. That's why we get high, cause you never know when you're gonna go. Life's a bitch and then you die.
Kids, I knew this shit is rough doing your bid. When the cops came, you should have slid to my crib. I'm fucking black, no time for looking back, it's done. Plus, congratulations, you know you got a son. I heard he looks like ya. Why don't your lady write ya? Told her she should visit, that's when she got hyper. Flipping, talking about he acts too rough. He didn't listen, he be ripping while I'm telling him stuff. I was like, yeah, shorty don't care, she a snake too. I'm from with the beginning from that fake crew that hate you.
Hard to tell, I excel, then prevail. The mic is contacted, I attract clientele. My mic check is life or death, breathing a sniper's breath. I exhale the yellow smoke up the roof through righteous steps. Deep like the shining, sparkle like a diamond. Sneaker easily on the island in my army jacket. I'm in, hit the earth like a comet. Invasion, Nazis like the Afrocentric Asian. Half man, half amazing. Cause in my physical, I can't express through song. Delete stress like moon trend, then extend strong. I drink my wet with Medusa, give a nuck. I shit in hell from the lips that I'm lifting in hell. It ain't hard to tell.
Nas is the king of the show. Nas is the king of the show.
Ain't hard to tell.
Nas is the king of the show. Nas is the king of the show. Nas is the king of the show. Nas is the king of the show.
Life, life, life. I wonder, will it take me under?
Imagine smoking weed in the street without cops harassing. Imagine going to court with no trial. Lifestyle cruising blue behind my waters. No welfare supporters. More conscious of the way we raise our daughters. Days are shorter, nights are colder. Feeling like life is over. These snakes strike like a cobra. The world's hot, my son got knocked. Evidently, it's elementary. They want us all gone eventually. Trooping out of state for a plate. Knowledge and coke was cooked without the garbage. We'd all have the top dollars. Imagine everybody flashing. Fashion, designer clothes, lacing your click up with diamond rolls. Your people holding dough, no parole, no rubbers. Going raw, imagine law with no undercovers. Just some thoughts for the mind. I take it.
Smoking an Escobano, guzzle my second bottle. Hope I don't catch a homo. Grossing our net simultaneously, making me climb higher. Heinous crimes behind me. Search for can't find me. Fuck sadness. Had this been you, having this lavish habitual happiness at me, you wouldn't look back. But you would have sex on condominium roof decks. So anyone move next, I hit you with two texts. Rock the Roberto Cavalli, no shirt or convertible. Mozzie, my Colombiana mommy riding beside me. Every tat means something. That's my word on my body. I have to lean something with that. My first shotty, my niggas is ignorant. Put lead in your pigment. Just cause y'all was mad at all the years I was getting it. And 9-7 to 6, 9-8 to Bentley. Now it's the Ghost Phantom, and y'all can't stand them, but. Army jacket green and black with a square top pocket that snaps where the gas at. Pass that, not you. You hold cracks in your ass crack. I never did that. My socks
yo,
with my
I live it and I speak it. My religion is reefer. Big money in the most uninhibited freak to sleep with. My visions are realistic. Nothing's figurative. I can wish it into existence. God want this nigga to live. Blunt, big as a dread. I get high and forget who bled. Who we stomped, kicked in the head and who we left for dead. Who are you niggas? Why are you niggas? The truth is the truth. I really put my scars on niggas. They wear them like. Time. They tell they hoes Nas did this. Pointing to their scars like right here, baby, really Nas did this. Like a badge of honor, not bragging, I'm just honest. War stories we tell them, nothing's realer than karma. Sip prohibition liquor, prohibition whiskey. Rap Jack Dempsey, Matt Black, Bentley, Pimply. Shattering your salads, pass around a chalice due to my Indian ancestry at the weed dispensary. Official kings and gents who I mix and mingle with. Fuck your ice, I rock rubies, amethyst. I fuck your wife and she a groupie, scandalous. This for my bad hood bitches. Ghetto glamorous.
Yo, what we talking about, niggas?
Y'all ready for
what we talking about, niggas? This is Nas. At 17, I made 17,000 living in public housing. Integrity intact, repping hard. They asked how he disappeared and reappeared back on top. Saying Nas must have naked pictures of God or something to keep winning. It's my way like Francis. As long as I'm breathing, I take chances. A soldier coming home 20 years old with no legs, saying there's no sense to cry and complain. Just go ahead. So much to write and say, yo, I don't know where to start. So I'll begin with the basics and flow from the heart. I know you think my life is good cause my diamond piece, but my life been good since I started finding peace. I shouldn't even be smiling, I should be angry and depressed. I've been rich longer than I've been broke, I confess. I started out broke, got rich, lost paper, then made it back. Like Trump being up, down, up, play with cash.
My niggas like a locomotive. Nas, push it, push it. Queensbridge to push it. No, Harlem, no, Bronx, no, all that. You ain't even supposed to be out here, you know where you at?
At night, New York, eat a slice too hot. Use my tongue to tear the skin hanging from the roof of my mouth. Shit was Felicimo, melted pot, city sweltering hot. Staggering, drunkering, them cops at Tupac shop. I was a crook by the train with the iron thing, concealed reaching. Soon as I heard them iron wheels screeching. When it came to a halt, whoever walked off got caught. Token man safe behind a locked door for sure. Minor thief shit, minor league shit, beast.
Welcome back, welcome back, welcome back. I want to say, send a shout out to Nas. It's his birthday today, so that's why we were playing that music. We had to show him some love. But whether you just tuned in or you've been rocking with us since 5 p.m., I appreciate you. I want to introduce you to our special guest, Steve Face Riley. Welcome to the DMV.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Good to be here.
Yeah, I know that you are eager to help the up-and-coming artists in the area to excel to the next level. What made you move here?
Well, what made me move here basically was kind of family. my mom's family is actually from Maryland. Mm-hmm. So they've been in the area for quite a while now.
Okay.
I'm just relocating here. Some personal stuff going on, so to help out the family, I kind of relocate. But I'm kind of between New York a lot of the times, between here in New York and Atlanta most of the time.
Okay.
So I'm just trying to put down some roots here now, and since I've been here in the territory, you know, I've been kind of hearing about some things that need to be done in this territory as far as helping these artists, and, you know, I got the background and the experience and all that, so I think, it's my time to be here, and I think it's really time for me to help out.
That's what's up. All right. So I know that you are a veteran in the music industry.
20 years.
And that you begin working with Bad Boy.
Yes,
that's
ma'am.
That's what's up. Okay, so tell me about how you got that opportunity and what knowledge did you gain from working with them?
Well, this goes back a while as far as the Bad Boy situation. That was high school. I was in high school when I was dealing with that switch situation, doing some internships. It wasn't actually official internship. I was working with a guy named June Balloon at the time, mm-hmm. which June actually ran the whole street team for Bad Boy at that time.
Totally.
And that was... I don't even think people know what street teams are anymore, but street teams were basically promotion on the street where you went out and you put up posters and different things like that. So
yeah.
I was kind of running with June. June was doing that, and he had us as far as like a little crew and of us teenagers at the time running behind him.
Mm-hmm.
And this was the time actually, Puff wasn't even Puff at that time.
Yeah.
To be honest with you.
Wow.
But Yeah, he was dancing. He's doing this dancing thing, and I think Rare Essence.
Mm-hmm.
He was doing some stuff with Rare Essence up here in D.C. at the time. But yeah, that's how I started as an intern on the street team. And my first thing as far as doing anything as far as the business was helping promote the whole Biggie situation. Actually, the crazy thing was it wasn't even Big at the time. It was an artist named Craig Mack,
mm-hmm.
that we was promoting at the time with Bad. That was our first artist on Bad Boy.
Okay.
But we had kind of had like a dual situation where Puff had two singles,
mm-hmm.
that he couldn't really decide which one he really wanted to do. So we kind of had an A and B side thing going on where he did an A and B side CD.
Mm-hmm.
We had Big on one side, Craig Mack on the other. And, you know, the crazy thing at that time was we used to go around the streets handing out Big Mac actual, you know, the thing that the Big Mac's coming.
Yeah, the box. Yeah.
But we actually had the CD in that.
Oh, dope.
And okay. I was like, yeah, I mean, Puff was genius. He's still a genius.
That's
but
creative.
Yeah, it was very creative at that time. Nobody was doing that.
Right.
So we was going around the streets handing those things out. And kind of that's how I kind of whole started the whole situation for me as far as the music industry on that time.
Okay.
And before that, actually, I was an artist myself.
Okay.
I used to sing in a group, in a singing group.
Okay.
Back in the day, yeah.
Look
so.
At you, all right. Okay, learn something new today. That's what's
yeah,
up.
But yeah, I've come a long way.
Okay, so what did you learn from that experience? Because a lot, you know, a lot of internships they come and they go, and a lot of people say, okay, well, I didn't really learn anything from the internship. But you know, sometimes it's just about the experience and getting yourself out there and trying something new. You know what
well,
I'm saying?
Well, it's the experience, but you got to take in what it is too.
Yeah.
Some people don't take internships very seriously.
That's true.
They kind of do it as something that just to do, but they're not looking at the future in it.
Right.
You know what I mean? Because a lot of times, you know, internships are not paid, and especially these days, you know, these kids, these younger generation of kids these days, they kind of want everything right now and then, but they don't really want to put the time in if it's not a paid situation.
That's true.
But sometimes you got to look at the bigger picture.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and at that time, I wasn't, to be honest with you, but at that time I was young too. I didn't really look at the bigger picture at that time either.
Mm-hmm.
Because it wasn't really a, like I said, an official intern situation.
Mm-hmm.
But then when I got into college, I actually got back with Bad Boy.
Okay.
And I was interning in the publicity department.
Oh.
And so I was doing an official internship in the publicity department.
Mm-hmm.
I was working with Mary J. at the time. Mary J. Blige, 112. I worked with 112. I worked with Jodeci. That was their first thing.
Okay.
And so I was an official publicist for Bad Boy for a few years.
That's
and I was actually Craig Mack's assistant.
Flavin' you.
Yeah. So
I got you.
Yeah, I started doing my thing then.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's what's up. I learned something new. You know what I mean? Because let me say this. I work for this man. I am A&R for FMBMC. So I learned a little bit of something new today, and that's what's up too. Like, you just never know, you know, everybody's full history, but that's some great information. I appreciate you for sharing that. Now let me ask you this. What made you decide to start a management and consulting company?
Okay. Me getting into management and consulting actually became of the situation where I was in a singing group a long time ago when I first started out trying to get into music.
Mm-hmm.
And we actually had a few opportunities as far as major situations with some major labels. We actually, the group actually was called 4x4. I don't know if this was back in 82. Like from 81 to actually 82, we were doing our thing, called 4x4.
Uh-huh.
And actually got a situation with Capitol Records, which we got to do one single. And the problem was we had my uncle managing us.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if you're not a professional manager as far as like entertainment, it's very hard to navigate.
Right.
You can't, you know, my uncle did, you know, he was a lawyer, but he did like corporate law and real estate and stuff like that. And he didn't really have a lot of experience as far as the entertainment industry goes.
Right.
So he made a lot of mistakes.
Yeah.
Because he really didn't know what was going on, missed a lot of opportunities. And kind of his style didn't really mesh mm-hmm. with a lot of people in the industry because he didn't, like I said, when you don't know how to navigate
mm-hmm.
and really learn the terms and the you'll have a hard time.
Yeah, it'll make it difficult.
Very, very much.
You have to be able to speak the language and understand, you know, what kind of offers they bring to the table. You know, and if you don't know, like you said, you'll miss out.
Yes.
So
yes, you definitely will.
Well, let me ask you this. Mm-hmm. Who are you currently managing?
I'm currently managing and consulting an artist named Dirty Black.
Okay.
He's from Detroit. He's originally from Detroit, lives in Mississippi, and kind of does a lot of stuff in Arkansas, also Hope, Arkansas right now, which actually got him a situation. He has a situation right now with MVT, a label called MVT Records.
Mm-hmm.
Sugo Music Group is the distributor, which they're a digital distribution company. They're independent major through Sony Red.
Okay, that's what's
so
up.
That's the situation I have as far as management right now.
Right, right.
With him. To be honest with you, management, and this is for a lot of up and coming managers and everything that want to really get into the management side of the game. It's the hardest job you will ever come across in the entertainment industry. Management.
Yes, Lord.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's very hard because, for one, you got to navigate and kind of be able to deal with everybody's personalities as far as the artists are concerned. Yeah. Most artists, you know, they kind of have a plan that they want to follow, their own plan.
Mm-hmm.
But sometimes when they get into a situation where they get professional management, they don't know how to basically take advice.
Yeah, I've you know noticed that a lot, you know, when it comes to artists. And it's a hindrance to them as far as them going further in their career.
Yes,
and they don't even
is.
Realize it, you know?
Yeah. You got to be open. You can't know it all.
Yeah.
Because if you knew it all, you would be farther along than where you are. You wouldn't even really need a manager.
Right. Exactly.
You know? But it gets to the point where you can't, you know, you can't do everything yourself. You know what I'm saying? And like you said, you know, you stress the team effort and the part of that, because that it takes a team to get you to that next level.
Right. Indeed. So, all right. Well, that's the end of that portion, but we're going to come back. But before we go, I want to make sure that you follow Steve at Faces Music Biz. That's FacesMusicBiz for Twitter. And for Facebook, it's steve.riley33483 for Facebook. And his website is www.facesmusicbiz.com. If you're currently considering management, send your EPK to aturnerfmbmc@gmail.com, and I'll get back to you. As I said, I am his A&R at FMBMC, and I'll check out your EPK, and hopefully, if it's something that fits your management company, maybe something will work out and you'll be able to go to the next level. We'll see. All right, we're going to go into a commercial. And when we come back, we'll give you the tips of how to attract a manager as opposed to you going to a manager. And we'll also speak about artist development. So grab your pens. We'll be back. Same faces. WWEN Radio 92.4 is now accepting music submissions for spins. All music submissions must be properly ID3 tagged and in MP3 format only. Please include pic, bio, and all contact information. For spin consideration, send submissions to wwenradio@gmail.com. And for package information, check out wwenradio924.blogspot.com. Welcome back, welcome back, welcome back. So here are the few tips to ensure a manager is coming to you. Your music needs to be creating a buzz and getting great feedback outside of family and friends. You'll need a manager to sell your music to producers, to your labels and agents and management firms. Is there anything else you wanted to add as far as tips to have a manager seeking the artist instead of the other way around?
Well, one of the things that I definitely stress is professionalism.
Mm-hmm.
That's really important. There's a lot of artists, there's a lot of great talent, but what I find and what will hinder artists a lot is professionalism, attitude.
Mm-hmm.
You know, of course, we know a lot of times our music is great and everything like that, but you have to have a great attitude in order for management, professional management. I'm not talking about people off the street that claim to be managers and things of that nature. I'm talking about professional managers that can actually get you a deal, can get you a distribution situation or whatever the case may be on the next level. They're not going to deal with a lot of artists that have attitude problems.
Right.
Or have, you know, problems as far as business-wise. I don't know the business. You don't even have to know all the business, but know some business.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Have a little business sense. Read up on what management is about. And another thing that I see, to be honest with you, and I will take heed to this too, management is not booking. Okay?
Man.
A lot of times we get into this thing where artists, they think, man, you know, just because you're in management, you're supposed to get them shows. And
yes.
It's not the same.
Right.
Okay? And it should never be. The thing is, it's called double dipping.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? It's never, never a good thing when your management is also booking you.
Right.
Okay?
What they don't understand is, I'm explaining to you why. And when he said double booking or double dipping,
yeah,
is it's because you're already paying your manager 15%, right? Or whatever the percentage is that you decided on with your contract and your agreement. And then on top of that, a booking agent gets the percentage too. So that means he's getting paid twice to do something for you. And then you really want that manager to focus on just the management. You don't want them focusing on anything else. Let them do their job. So my thing is, if you don't have enough revenue to afford a booking agent and a manager, you might want to hold off on one or the other and do it yourself for a while. You're going to have to wear all these hats until you're ready to, and you're prepared for the next level, because otherwise you're wasting your time, you know what I'm saying, and everybody else's time if you're not prepared. So just keep that in mind when you say that you're ready for a manager. it's not free for one, you know what I'm saying? Because this person is taking time out of their day. Yes, they're going to do their job to the fullest, but they're taking time out of their day to push you to the next level. And they're using their resources that they've gained over the years, you know, in their relationships right. to help you go to the next level. They don't have to work with you. You know right. what I'm saying? So right. you need to be up to par and business oriented too, in order for everything to run smooth. So I just want to say that part of it.
And another thing too, as far as management is concerned, you have to have something to manage. Okay.
Oh, man. yeah.
Because, you know, just because you're doing music or whatever the case may be, if you're not doing it on a certain level where you have created a fan base
right.
and you have a product that can move and that your manager can actually use to get you deals, to get you sponsorships and things of that nature, it's a moot point.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So you have to have something to bring to the table in order to attract a manager in the first place.
Right, exactly.
Because a manager is not going to just deal with you unless they see some kind of income coming in. Because remember, this as management, you don't get paid up front. You right. get paid basically from whatever deals you might bring to the table or right. whatever deals that you guys can actually work out, but that you have to have a fan base. You have to be able to move product. And if you can't do that, then you should definitely think about creating that type of situation first.
Right. It's commission based. We get paid based off of what you do. You know what I'm saying? And if you're just sitting at home recording in your closet, like, there's no reason for you to even have a manager. You're not ready for it yet. So it's levels to it. You know right. what I'm saying? And so you have to ensure that, again, it's worth you sitting down and trying to talk about a contract with a manager. Again, it's business. It's not a friendship type of thing. You need to make sure that you have everything lined up so that you can move forward. Because let's say, for instance, that, okay, you get a manager and you're not ready. You don't have enough music to even push to a label. You know, you have to start from scratch. You have to be prepared. Yes. So, but that's where artist development comes in. And then we're going to get ready to talk about that.
Yeah, it's very important. Very, very important that you have some type of... Talent always comes first, but... It's 90% business in kind of like 5 to 10%, even if it's that much talent wise, to be honest with you.
Yeah. Based off what we've seen. Yeah.
Yeah.
To be honest.
Yeah. And that's what is not being said, because there's a lot of promoters that run around saying that they can basically manage you and this and that and this and that, but you're still stuck in the same position you was 3-4 years ago.
Right.
You know what I mean? And that's not a good thing. That's never a good thing.
Yeah. You want growth when you go to a manager.
Oh, yeah.
That's the whole point of going to the manager in the first place. It's like you've gotten to a point where you've reached the ceiling and now it's time to go further. That's
right.
what a manager is for. You know,
right.
that's what the team is for, is to help you go to the next level. And it's based off of what, you know, the vision is for that artist too. Not everybody wants to be on radio. Not everybody wants to perform at these big shows and big concerts and sell to millions of people. You know what I mean? But at the end of the day, you have to have some type of idea of what you want to do.
Yes.
And be focused and put in your work too. You know, like, this is my thing. They feel like a manager is supposed to do everything for them. You know what I'm saying? Or better yet, they want the manager to pay for things.
Yeah, that's not how it works. You should be able to have a budget. If you don't have one, a manager can actually help you create one.
Right.
And one thing I'd run into a lot of is, I don't have a budget. Okay. But the problem is, you have a budget, but you just spend your budget on all the wrong things.
Right.
The money that you could, because when you talk about going into the studio and recording, you have to pay for that.
Right.
You have to pay for studio time. You got to pay for all this promotional marketing materials and different things like that. So it's the way you spend your budget.
Right,
okay?
Exactly.
Because you do have a budget. I mean, if you're going out there spending, you know, and I'm not knocking people, but if you're going out there spending I've seen people talking about they spending like $500 on sneakers and stuff like that. Now, seriously, that's your budget you spending
right.
on your, you know what I'm saying,
right.
on footwear.
Yeah, that's studio time. That's distribution. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's things that can help you go further with your career.
It's the mindset.
Yeah, it's not about how you look at the moment. We can get the stylists together. You know what I'm saying? After the fact. Matter of fact, you can even get sponsors to donate clothing. You know what I'm saying to you? You don't have to worry about that part.
Most
Focus
national
on the
artists,
music and getting that
most
right.
Most national artists don't even buy their own clothes.
Exactly.
You understand? So
that's
like,
what I'm saying.
You know, it's not about, it's about what you do with the money that you are spending. You don't have to have a crazy budget, but it's, if you budget right and spend your money on the right things and not on all the wrong things, then you can have a career, because it's going to take money for you to have a career. Don't get that twisted at all.
Right.
Because this business is about capital. This business is about money. And there's always services that you have to pay for, that you're going to have to pay for.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You can't get too far without a budget. You know, like I said, you don't have to have $1 million budget or whatever the case may be, but you do have to have something and spend your money, save some money.
Right. Exactly.
You know what I mean? Save some money. Don't go to the club popping bottles and spending money on bottles to look good.
Right.
When you spend, that's your money. That's all your budget you're spending right there.
Right. Well, to be honest with you, you need to focus on budgeting your money anyway, because let's say if you got, you signed to with Steve with his FMBMC, right? And you got them a deal, you know what I'm saying, with a label.
Right.
That money that you get up front is not for you to go buy houses and cars.
That's
and
a loan you got to pay.
Exactly.
Back.
You know what I'm saying? It's for your music to be pushed and make sure that it's a product that will bring in revenue. So if you focus on that and practice on that ahead of time, then you don't have to worry about if you can handle the budget later on when it's time to get signed. Focus on that right now. And I also want to say this, when it comes to artist development, that's not, we're not cussing you out, artists. I don't know, for some reason y'all get upset when we say artist development. Artist development could mean several different things. It can mean you may need to work on your stage presence. It can mean that, you know, maybe you need to go back in the studio and work on a different type of song, you know what I'm saying, that'll draw the right crowd, like the right fan base. You know what I'm saying? Like, artist development is not a bad thing. It's something that a manager is saying that you need to take time out to regroup and do certain things differently, but it's to help you move forward. It's not to pull you back and say, okay, well, you can't go forward and you're not ready to be signed. It's the reason why a manager is saying that. Like, they're trying to get you prepared for the right types of deals. He doesn't want to, or no, any other manager wants to sit there and present you to a label and both of y'all look crazy because you're not ready.
Right, exactly. You have to be ready. And artist development, just to kind of expand on that, is about having an initial plan. The problem is, a lot of times now, nobody goes into anything with a plan.
Right.
Everybody's just kind of winging everything and just, you know what I'm saying? And that's not good, because when you do that, you spend a lot of unnecessary money that you necessarily don't have to spend.
Right.
You know what I mean? So just always, you know, if a manager is not coming to you, and I'm not just talking about, because I'm not, you know, I've been doing this for a while, so I'm going to come to you with a plan. If someone's talking about their manager and they don't have an initial plan for you, whether it be a 6-month plan or a 12-month plan initially, as far as what they want to do with for you within 6 to 12 months, and they don't have no type of situation as far as anything on paper, then that's a red flag in itself right there.
Right.
You know
exactly
what I'm saying? So everybody's not a manager. You know what I'm saying? Like, everybody's not a manager. You have good people sometimes that wanna help you, but they're not professional management. And when you talk about professional management, now you're talking about going into situations where you have to have a plan done and you have to have some kind of blueprint.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you can't wing it. You have to have some kind of blueprint. And one thing as far as another advice as far as management.
Mm-hmm.
Your front on your block ain't your manager. I don't care who, if it's your cousin or your, you know what I'm saying, or a sister or a brother or whatever, they might have the best intentions for you. But if they haven't taken the time and got the experience and actually went out there and tried to get things done and read up on what they need to do for you in a professional way, it's not going to work.
Right. Yeah, it's going to hinder you. I know that when I managed for a little bit of time, when I was asked, you know, at first, I didn't know anything about, I knew about management because I was in the Navy, but that has nothing to do with the music industry.
Right.
You know what I mean? So I did a lot of research, reading books and looking at websites and stuff like that, but I wasn't quite sure if they were telling me the right things, because, you know, on the internet, they could tell you anything, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. So I went out and I asked, I got mentors to tell me, you know, that have experience in the industry, and I'm asking questions on what should I do with this and that. And then I decided, you know what, if I'm gonna be serious about this and really want to know more about the industry, I'm gonna go to school. So I know that everybody is not able to afford to go to school to a Berkeley or a Full Sail or a Musicians Institute, but that's okay. That's what this show is for. But in all honesty, if you want to be serious about being in the industry, you need to make sure that you have the knowledge and the terminology so that you're not being taken for granted and your money is not wasted. So,
right.
But let me say this. Thank you, Steve, for being my special guest.
Oh, no problem. Definitely glad to be here. Appreciate you having me.
You had gave a lot of great information. I learned a lot about, you know, the history of, you know, how you started. I appreciate you for being here. I want to say thank you, DJ Genius, for keeping the listeners entertained. You can follow them both on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. You can check out DJ Genius Show on Genius Music Radio on Mondays, Wednesdays, Thursdays from 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. Eastern, and Fridays 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. Eastern. Thank you to all my listeners across the globe. Much love. Special shout out to my son, Xavier. My love, Estevan Garvin, family and friends who support me unconditionally. Thank you. I love you all to the moon and back. And now we will take a break. And when we come back, we'll have the Indie Artist Spotlight.
What's poppin', world? It's the Bronx Bomber, G-O-D, the CNC of Gangstertainment, Inc. And I'm riding with DJ Genius, the hottest DJ in the game. Ha, ha, ha.
All right, thanks for coming back. And now we'll go into our Indie Artist Spotlight. We're going to play T.O.P., Four Seas from Beyonce, and D. Black, MVP.
Ammo, calico, jacket made out of animal.
All right.
Videos go viral. Fly speed, you ever saw. Came from a dark place. I went from the slums to Parkland to Parkland. Front row at the Barclay.
Bars.
Four Seas from Beyonce.
Four Seas from Beyonce. Four Seas from Beyonce. Four Seas from Beyonce.
When I started out, I was nothing but the little ugly kid. Eyebrows thick as hell, braces home before I was 12. Sitting in the kitchen, granny about to press my hair. Mama had good, but I ain't get that debt. Daddy made sure I was good so I could get that debt. Anything I wanted, ask for it, and he's on it. On it. Story makes you think I was rich, don't it, this, never, I ain't never been broke. But as far as the mind goes, always had bags of gold in my flow. Leprechaun, just afraid of my rainbow. You know, H-U, coming for your neck, you coming for the crew. Always been T, you just had to let it brew. I'm like Stuart off Man TV.
Look what I can do.
Work hard, play hard. Show fans love, gotta keep the charger on deck. But I ain't always had the juice, but now I'm OJ and you can keep the food. It's the come up season, why you trying to shoot? You like Elmer Fudd and I'm Elmer's glue. I stick to my craft, stick to my truth. Now I'm 4 seats away singing Deja Vu.
Deja.
4 seats from Beyonce. 4 seats from Beyonce. Come up. 4 seats from Beyonce. 4 seats from Beyonce. Come up. 4 seats from Beyonce. 4 seats from Beyonce. Come up. 4 seats from Beyonce.
still seats from the loose, yeah. Refuse to be the one touching the wall in the back of the arena. While the axe on stage is looking small as a peanut. But you up so high, you sneeze too hard and you might see Jesus. Save your creature. Student turn into the teacher. Moving down from them high ass bleachers and box seats where I see my features. Could've stayed there, yet a view real nice. Nights only gets one slice. Nights only cuts with a knife. Nights only gets one night. I'm a real line crawl. Got the ball rolling, now you know I'm gonna score. Now do you get...
I know I let you like you love me. My OGs go hard like Kobe. Go hard in the paint like dribbling in the bank. Can't tell me this, tell me this falling. Top pick, she roll, I'm scoring. My nigga free to go to stay warrior. Retire, shoot it like Jordan. Say how I feel like I'm Jordan. Cause I'm balling. I'm balling like I'm MVP. Okay, I'm balling. I'm balling like I'm MVP. I'm ballin', I'm out of control, got a pad in the shot like Ginobili. She double teamed me, they can't hold me. My got strikes that don't hold me. Pull me an eight like a young Kobe. I'm there when you need me like Horan. Keep a rocket in the shooter like Harden. My big game, this ain't rockin'. Pass that gas like Stockton. I'm gone to top coffee. Phil Jackson, they ain't stoppin'. Funny now, Dennis Rodman. He gets no love like Compton. It's the last second shot and I got it. First round pick, got rookie of the year. Hit the trap hard, get ready for next year. Looking for the best of best, it's right here. Four winning cookie, what the f*** I feel. Boy going in, had an all-star year. KD and MJ probably crushed for the hate. Gonna get mad, it's never a day. Smoke a Kyle Kai, he like, yeah, Wizard with the work like Wall. Line on the track like LeBron. I think I'm going back to the track. I'm MVP cause I'm falling like that. Never took an L, got rings to vouch that. Work like Wall, land on the track like LeBron. I think I take it back to the track. I'm in B, ball it, dash, blast, blast. And that's you, G, hard in the paint, like dribbling in the paint. Can't tell me this, falling.
You've tuned in to Why Wait, Educate Now. And next week's guest is going to be DJ Genius, CEO of Genius Music Radio. We'll discuss royalties and points, business with producers. Thank you for tuning in. I'll see you. God bless.
Roll, I'm scoring. My nigga free to go to stay warrior. Retire, shoot it like Jordan. Say how I feel like I'm Jordan. Cause I'm ballin'. I'm ballin' like I'm MVP. Okay, I'm ballin'. I'm ballin' like I'm MVP. Like Derrick Rose, she had nigga number one. She a freak, so I'm feeling in the butt. Call me Wilt Chamberlain, that nigga traffic. Like Bird with the three, I'm busting. Go back to your man, ain't cuffing. No.
Yeah, let's get it.